all. So again, today we are going to start with the next lecture, which is a lecture number 31, based on the right characteristic of the tire, the size and the load rating, and the finally it is a balancing of the tire. In the previous lecture that we actually discussed about the tire configuration, that means how to read the tires. So regarding this, we have actually seen two different types of tire, that is a for four wheel vehicle as well as a two wheel vehicle. So see, we are going to revise it again. So like suppose if it is written P205-55VR16. So here P basically representing nothing, it is just for the passenger vehicle. 205 basically representing especially for in terms of millimeter. We can also represent the same thing in terms of inches for the two wheel also. 55 basically representing is the aspect ratio. Aspect ratio, that means it is a ratio of height to the weight in terms of percentage. It is representing in terms of percentage, that means it is a 55% right now. Next, V basically representing is the speed ratio, or we can say the speed rating. Like Z basically representing if the speed is more than 150 miles per hour, then we use Z. If we use V, that means it is for the moderate speed. B representing for the slow speed type of vehicle. So next, R basically representing the type of tire, either it is a radial tire, either it is a bias tire, or either it is a belted type of tire. So here B representing for the bias belted. There is a one more symbol we generally use, that is a D. D representing for the belted bias tire. Sorry, the bias tire, general bias tire. The ply base, this is for the belted base. So this is the difference. And 16 basically representing the rim diameter in terms of inch. That is a 13 inch or 14 inch or 16 inch. So that we can actually use. Same manner, like if we are talking about a two-wheeled vehicle, so if this coding has been written here, what is the meaning of that code? The first term is actually representing nothing, it is the tire width. Next one representing the tire height in terms of percentage, that means it is an aspect ratio again. And 18 basically representing here is the in terms of inch. So that basically we need to use. So this is the representation of the two-wheeled vehicle. Now coming to the next. Next, representing the special service type of tire. Basically, we use a special service type of tire. Basically, we can say it is a spare tire or a stepney tire that is actually used to replace the flat tires. It is not used specifically for the rotation. We actually use for the specific application only. So that's why it is actually known as it is used for the special wheel. So speed and the pressure restrictions is actually applied. That means we cannot use at a high speed. We cannot use a lesser pressure. The specified pressure has to be used. There is no hub cap or the wheel cover has to be used for the specific vehicle. This is a temporary type of tire only. You already know, if you see in a vehicle, there is a one spare tire you actually using, that is actually representing the special service type of tire. We cannot use as a main tire, it is a special tire. Now coming to the next one basically representing is the size and the load rating. What is the size and the load rating? This is actually representing again in terms of tire. When you're talking about a size, how to identify the size and how to denote the size. So we already seen in the previous figure, we talking about the section height, we talking about the section width, we talking about the rim diameter. So same term are actually using here in terms of size. So read this. The tire size is denoted by one of several methods variously including the section height. What is the section height? There is a representing the distance from bead seat to the outer extreme of the treads. This is the section height. And the section width basically representing the maximum width across the shoulder of the tire. Aspect ratio, the ratio of height to the width in terms of percentage we are talking about here. And this and the next one is the rim diameter. You already know what is the rim diameter. So when we are talking about the size and the rating of the tire, so basically there is a one association basically works, that is known as the tire and the rim association, that defines what can be the designated tire we actually use as per the different loading condition as per the vehicle. So suppose if we are talking about a bias tire, if it is written 6.95-40, that it is representing both in terms of inch. So first one representing for the section width, next one basically representing the rim size. Same like if it is a radial tire, then R term will be there, 175 representing the section width and 40 representing the rim diameter. Or either we can also representing in the same manner, like a passenger vehicle, 75 is the width, 70 is the aspect ratio, R for the radial, 40 is for the inch diameter. That means it is a rim diameter. So this is representing the tire size specifications. And what is load rating? We are going to discuss in the coming slide. So you are able to see one figure that representing it, numerous codings are there. So we already discussed these complete coding, what is it representing here. Next one basically representing is the load index. Load index basically representing what is the design load and what is the rate load. So accordingly we need to calculate the load rating. That means the design life and the actual load. So the we actually calculating the ratio. If the ratio is coming up to 95% or the 100%, 100% basically it is not possible, but we generally manage the load rating less than 100%. So that is representing here in this simple coding. That is a 95H like this. M plus S representing it is a severe snow condition. That means suppose if you are using a vehicle, which vehicle is actually specifically used only at the snow related conditions. So that actually represented also here. Next, you're able to see 2 into X chord. That means it is representing the plies information that is actually written at the side at the circumference. Okay, what is a ply? What type of material actually used for the making a ply? What is the load rating is also written there. Tread wear, traction, and the temperature grade. That means what is the maximum temperature range, what is the traction force, what is the tread wear. All informations you are able to see written on the tire. As well as what can be the maximum permissible inflammation pressure we can use for the tire. So each and every information is actually written there. Now load rating, what is the load rating? That means how much weight the tire can safely support at a specific air pressure. That means how much area of the tire that at specific pressure that actually bearing that amount of weight, that is representing the load rating. So when we're talking about a load rating, there's a one rating is also known as, that is known as a gross weight rating. The gross weight rating can be represented by GVW, or it can also be known as GVWR, which includes the complete weight of the vehicle, passenger plus the luggage weight. So there is a one more weight is actually known as a curb weight. Curb weight is actually different from the gross weight. Curb weight basically representing only the weight of the vehicle without passenger and the luggage. That means it is just a weight of the vehicle, that's it. But the gross weight basically representing considering the passenger and the luggage weight also. So there is a dot symbol basically that signifies the tire meet as per the dot safety standards. What is a dot? Dot basically representing the Department of Transportation. They actually specify some standards, so that standard has to be followed while designing the tire. So accordingly we need to manage some standards. So what can be the cross section, what can be the size, what can be the load rating. So each and every information has to be surpassed first from the DOT. That means the DOT symbols or same standard has to be followed. Next topic is the tubeless tire. Tubeless tire basically is also known as inner liner bonded type of tire. Basically we use inner liner bonded specifically for to seal the air. That means there should be a leak proof type of connections or leak proof type of joint has to be created between the rim and the tire. That means there is no tube is actually used. So this is actually thicker than the tubeless type of tire if I am using a liner. Safety type of tire we can also use as a tubeless tire, because if we compare the tubeless tire with the tube type of tire, tubeless tire actually having more advantages over the tube-based tire. So what are the biggest advantage? It does not get flat when punctured. That means when the air will get escape out through tire due to the puncture, so that means it will not suddenly get flat. So it means some air will get sustained because it is almost thicker as compared to the normal tire. So that's why this is the biggest advantage. The life of the tubeless tire is much greater than the tube type of tire, because in a tube type of tire basically we need to replace the tube again and again, but here the life of the tubeless tire is much higher. But one more disadvantage of the tubeless tire is that the costing of the tubeless tire is much higher than the tube based of tire. So that is the biggest disadvantage. We cannot say it is actually biggest disadvantage. Basically if we increase some advantages, some cost factor will also include. So this is actually the main reason. Next here, very common term which is actually talked about, if we use a radial as well as a bias ply tire in a same vehicle. So we generally prefer the radial tire has to be used at the rear side and the cross ply tire basically used at the front side. We cannot mix radial and the cross ply tire at the same axle. Suppose if I'm talking about at the rear axle, I connect radial as well as a cross tire. One side at the radial and other side actually connected to the cross ply tire. It creates an imbalance. It will never be fitted like this. So this is the biggest, that means we can say it is the not recommended type of suggestions are there. Okay, we cannot use a combination of these two at the same axle. Reason being, because of the imbalance, some extra force or some lateral force generated due to that one, system becomes unstable in the situation. As well as tire pressure must be set as per the manufacturer's recommendation. If it is given 35 psi, so we have to follow the same standard. Otherwise, it will not give you the specific life as per the decided by the manufacturers. The tread and the sidewall must be free from the large cut abrasion and the bubble. So that means this is again, if the treads and the sidewalls, which is actually totally free from the large cut abrasion and the bubble. So these, you are able to see the figure that representing the treads, this is representing sidewalls, this is representing the beads, this is a bead wire, this is the inner lines. Again, it is representing the complete schematic of the tire. This is for the radial vane and this is for the bias ply tire, or we can say the cross ply tire. So in the bias ply tire, you are able to see numerous plies has been used at a different high angle chord, 35 to 40 degree. Here we use a low angle chord that is actually 15 degree to 20 degree. This is representing here the carcass. Over the carcass, we actually using in numerous belts. Then after, at the top, we actually using a treads. Below the treads, basically there is a crown. So we already discussed this thing, that is the terminologies for the tire. Now coming to the next, the balancing. When we talking about the balancing, so balancing of a complete vehicle basically comes first from the tires. If the tire is actually not balanced properly, it creates some unstable forces. So due to that unstable force, the directional stability will get loosened up. So how to make it vehicle balanced, or how to make it wheel balanced? Basically there are two methods which is actually mostly preferred. For the first method is a static balancing, second method basically known as a dynamic balancing. Static means during the stationary condition, and dynamic basically when the vehicle is actually spinned, and due to that condition how much misbalancing is going on and how to make it balanced. So same has to be used. So when the vehicle actually having at high speed, due to some centrifugal force, due to some heavy weight, it actually acts in the outward direction. So that is representing the imbalance. To make it balanced, we generally prefer the dynamic balancing, or in common terms we also known as a wheel balancing. So in wheel balancing, you already seen, we actually attach some masses over the rim. So because attaching that masses, the wheel becomes balanced in nature. So that means some extra lateral force and imbalance force actually acting on the system will get reduced, or it can be neglected as per the balance condition. Next is the changing of the tire size. If we changing the tire size, what can affect? So first of all, if we change the tire, then substitute of the tire that we actually use, that can having a load carrying capacity will be higher, or as well as if I increase the diameter of the tire, the load carrying capacity will get increased. So read this one. I'm talking about the tire size increase. I'm not talking about the rim size. There's two types of sizes are there: tire size and rim size. Tire size means the circumference of the tire will be, if you are increasing, or if you are increasing the rim diameter. Maybe the diameter of the rim will be same and the tire size will be different. That means I can connect numerous tire at a same vehicle. So I'm talking about the same thing here. So diameter of the tire size increase, that means the load carrying capacity will also get increased. If we use a low profile based tire, that means which is actually very wider tire and the large diameter basically it is used. Low profile means the lower edge which is actually in contact, or it is also known as a contact patch between the road and the ground. This is basically wider in nature and the large in diameter. If we talking about overall diameter of the replacement of tire, we generally considered plus 2 to 3% of the original tire. That means if the overall diameter has to be replaced, so this condition has to be fulfilled. That means 2 to 3% of the original tire. So if we change the tire, very important thing, if we change the tire, we need to recalibrate the speedometer, otherwise the reading will not get the exact, because the tire diameter will get changed. That means circumference will get changed. If the circumference will get changed, maybe the effect on speedometer, not maybe, it is surely it will affect the speedometer. So speedometer will not give you the exact value. So the same figure you are able to see here, that we have three different type of sizes, which is actually basically of same size. We have three different rim size. The tire size meter is same. Suppose in that situation, you can see the three different codings are written: the P195-60R15, P205-50R16, P215-40R17. So here, all three basically representing for the passenger vehicles, 195, 205 and 250 representing the section width. So you are able to see three different widths are there. 60 representing the aspect ratio, that means height to the weight ratio, width ratio. Same for here and same for here, that means 50 and 40. This is 15 inch, this is for 16 inch, and this is for the 17 inch. So you can see plus sizing maintains the same diameter tire assembly by using a larger width and lower tire profile. So you can see, if I increase the plus 2, the profile becomes very wider in nature. That means the lower profile becomes very wider in nature. So due to that wider in nature, what basically going on? Read this. this statement. Lower profile tire if I install, wider tire size will be there and the large diameter wheel we can use. So this is the representation of if you change the tire as per the specifications. So what can be the possibility? So that we actually discussed here. So if any doubt, let me know. I'll discuss the same over the LPU. That means the LPU library. Okay, thank you.